My name is Dr. Kiri Purdy. I'm a certified dermatologist and I practice in Halifax, Nova Scotia. Eczema is a very common skin condition. Some people call it dermatitis, and essentially what that means is inflamed or irritated skin. There's different types of eczema. So sometimes people are born with a tendency to eczema, and those people are what we would consider quote unquote atopic. And we tend to see that that runs as well with things like asthma and seasonal allergies. There's other types of eczema where people will develop it through their life because of different exposures. So for example, through their occupation or through other things that have contacted their skin. The common symptoms of eczema would essentially be that the skin can be red, itchy, inflamed, sometimes flaky. Sometimes it's so inflamed that people even notice what look like water-filled bubbles or blisters on their skin. And it can involve small areas of the skin, or it can involve essentially the entire skin surface. Different things that may be in everyday products that they're using. So for example, a preservative or something that makes your shampoo foam up. Fragrances that are in a variety of different products. Also, we think about it in terms of what their occupation may be. It would be relatively common to see a hairstylist or perhaps a dentist or dental assistant develop eczema on their hands because they're coming into contact regularly with different products that they could become allergic to. In terms of treatment for eczema, the way that I like to frame it for my residents or students when I'm teaching them is you have to think about it as two parts. So you want to think about it as the non-pharmacologic side of things and then the pharmacologic side of things. I think one of the key things with eczema is good skin health, good skin care. So I recommend that people take a daily bath without anything in it, that they pat dry and immediately apply emollient creams or good thick creams to their skin. We also sometimes add diluted bleach baths to help decrease the amount of bacteria that's on the skin. Then when I move on to the pharmacologic side of things, I think about creams. Sometimes they're steroid creams, sometimes they're non-steroid creams. Light treatments can be helpful. And we also have a variety of pills and also now injectable needles that we can use for treatment of eczema. I like to tell patients specifically that just because they've been given one cream doesn't mean that all creams are created equal or that they've necessarily been given the appropriate cream for their particular condition.